Hi everyone, welcome to Lumist. This video is about calculating the price elasticity of demand. First, let's review the definition of price elasticity of demand. It measures the sensitivity of quantity demanded given a price change. More mathematically, price elasticity of demand equals to the absolute value of the percentage change in quantity demanded divided by the percentage change in price. Given a demand curve or a demand schedule, there are generally two types of mathematical questions that we might encounter. What is the elasticity between point A and point B? As well as what is the elasticity at a single point, point A? To solve these two types of questions, we need to use two different methods. In this video, we're going to focus on how to solve arc elasticity. Arc elasticity is the elasticity that exists between two points on a demand curve. Let's say that we're given this demand curve for donuts. At a price of $6, our consumers will buy 80 donuts in total, which is our point A here. When the price decreases to $4 each, our consumers will increase their consumption to 120 donuts. So we now move from point A to point B. Now let's put these two points in a table and try to solve for the elasticity between them. First, we calculate the percentage change in quantity demanded, which equals to change in quantity divided by quantity. Change in quantity is easy. Quantity is increasing here from 80 donuts to 120 donuts. So the change here is 120 minus 80, which is 40. What about the denominator, our QD? Should it be 80, the donuts that we started with, or 120, the donuts we ended with? Well, for accuracy, we use the average of these two quantities, which should be 100. Now we have the numerator and the denominator, so we can solve for a percentage change in quantity demanded, which is 40%. Now we're going to use the same method to calculate percentage change in price. Our donuts were originally selling for $6, but now they're $4. So the change in price here is the difference, which should be negative $2. And we're going to use the average of these two prices again for the denominator, which is between 6 and 4, so it's $5. So here we have a negative 40% change in price. Finally, we can now solve for the arc elasticity between point A and point B, which is the percentage change in quantity demanded divided by the percentage change in price. And we take the absolute value. So this will give us an elasticity of exactly 1. So now we determine that the arc elasticity between point A and point B is unit elastic. Now get ready to take a screenshot or take some notes, because here is our general formula for calculating arc elasticity. Remember, we use the average value of the prices and quantities when we calculate the percentage change, right? So we call this method the midpoint method, because we're taking the average value. So today, we talked about what arc elasticity is, and we also learned to calculate arc elasticity using the midpoint method. Make sure you do some practice questions after this video and get comfortable with the application of this formula.